How's everyone doing? Open-minded people, keep your minds open. So, since we enjoyed Outkast so motherfucking much,
yeah,
we're gonna check out one off of, I think this was like one of their breakthrough albums.
They were listening to
Stankonia. It came out after Equimini.
Oh.
Because I remember back, like, growing up and, like, you know, like, being a teenager in the late 90s, yeah, early 2000s.
Because
Claude's, like, 5 years older than me, so. But being a teenager in, like, the late 90s or whatever, always seeing, like, you know, when MTV used to play fucking videos, you know? They always had Outkast, and especially off of this album. So we're going to check out B.O.B.
B.O.B. Outkast. Bombs over a Baghdad.
Get it going.
Got that high pitch that just gets me.
Stankonia.
Cool.
What do you think about the lyrics so far? You can understand everything he's saying. I can.
It's
like, but he's just going, bah-da-da-da-da-da-da, but he's spitting at like 100 miles an hour.
Yeah.
It's all just, I think it's all just life events. That's what it sounds to me. Like things that he's done or in the process of doing or what he looks forward or like from other people's perspectives. Like it's just, yeah, it's just a, the beat too. Like, oh my God.
I mean, it's just hearing it, it's not a, you know, I can, it's pretty cool. I could sit and just, you know, vibe on it or whatever, but I don't know. I'd have to hear it a bunch to really understand what he, what the song's about.
Some really,
maybe the lyrics. But. Yeah.
This in a club back then. It's a club song. Even like maybe the lyrics
probably
aren't that clubby. The fucking beat is just one of those turn up beats. You just want to blast the shit.
Yeah.
Especially when that fucking when that shit came in. Ooh,
right. Yeah. The second guy that came in.
Yeah, big boy.
I could understand a few more of his words.
Yeah.
And just but just his
the groove.
His groove with
him,
that beat.
Flowing
like,
with the beat.
Kit
yeah.
was carrying me. And it was
and
pretty
then adding that keyboard or whatever that was.
Bombs over Baghdad.
Drum machine, but if that, I wouldn't doubt it if that was an actual drummer. Like that shit, and that shit's tight too.
Yeah.
There's drummers that can pull that off. Tight as a motherfucker. Yeah.
Yeah.
Outkast just, yeah, they just have that sound. Unique. You hear that, you hear any of their beats, you know.
To me, and they bring a lot of 70s right beats.
Right?
And just,
and they're from Georgia, so bring it's a lot of that Southern age, influence, like even probably like bluesy, making it into hip-hop. Yeah,
Southern, what, where are they from?
Atlanta, I think.
Oh, from Georgia?
Yeah. Yeah. Playing
cool
the guitar, and then scratching over that
with the drum.
Like every element. And then you got the bass guitar in there, probably.
He's going quick with the solo, but not just.
Right, that guitar solo. He's just fire.
Yeah.
Melodically driving that through the beat. It's so cool.
Yeah.
That cool guitar line,
What's he saying?
Bow your head ragtop or bob your head ragtop?
I know, I hear the ragtop, but I think
bow your head.
Bow your head ragtop.
I think that's what he said. Let us know. What we want is
Bob your head ragtop.
Let us know.
Yeah.
And the whole choir back there.
It's like the whole town came out.
Right? It's like, let's get the whole community on this shit real quick. It sounds like a whole group of people.
There's like huge ass cue cards telling them what to say.
Just sing these parts.
Right.
All right, you guys are good. Okay. Maybe it was
B.O.B.
That was crazy, but maybe that was like the people that helped them make songs. That whatever they're saying right there, like before they say electric revival, what were they saying?
Music,
like,
something.
I O music, electric,
music
revival.
Electric revival.
Let us know. That was a great one.
Yeah, I'm curious as to what they were saying there at the end. Anyways,
we could have checked the lyrics out, but.
Yeah, the lyrics are sitting right there.
I said, "Fuck it, whatever."
Damn it.
Whatever.
Oh well.
You know,
that's cool.
I know we say in the disclosure,
I might have got the song a little better if I knew what they were saying.
Yeah. And I know what we say in a disclaimer in the beginning that we break the lyrics down.
But it's a groovy song. It's a groovy song.
Some songs we just groove to. So.
I just, you know, I would have to hear it a few more times, and I wouldn't be mad if somebody put it on. You know. Okay, let's hear it.
Another great Outkast song.
Yeah.
Shout out to them.
Opening
Shout out
the
to
mind.
Everyone requesting great music, great, you know, open-minded music.
Most deaf. Yeah.
Hit us up on Twitter.
We're on Twitter.
TwoDudes at Maine2.
Maine2. M-A-I-N-E-T-W-O.
We're also on Instagram.
We're on Instagram. And we're at TwoDudes207.
If you like metal, we are
Synthetic Slave.
We're a metal duo. Okay, it's just me and Claude on guitar. We both write our own tunes.
We record our own
We do all
videos.
The production.
Yeah, we have videos
acting,
out on all the songs. We have 6 songs, 6 videos, 6 demos for each song.
All the visual art in our videos is us. Yeah, if you guys are into like
the demo
like
album is called Seriously Hellish.
Metal, check us out.
It's pretty cool. Yeah, you got to hear it. Mind opening, groundbreaking metal.
We do our.
We try to tell stories.
Production's
outside
always a growing
of
field.
The Dungeons and Dragons.
Not yeah,
Dungeons
it's more
Dragons
like our
bad,
music's
like,
more survival. We write survival songs.
Redemption. All there's redemption in there, and like you know, rising above,
you know
the negative hate.
Yeah.
Drama, all that.
Not taking anything away from other metal, but there's a lot of metal that's about just war, like we said before. And, you know, that's some of the our favorite bands write about
type
of stuff. But our approach is survival and
we want to tell
uplifting and
to be honest,
stuff
like
that.
When we're writing, when we started, like, we didn't sit and listen to rap and stuff. We listened to metal and, like, so we were writing out lyrics and everything. But, like, some of the lyrics, like, not, like, are... stories like this, like, we have strife in our life, so we don't make it about us, but we write this story based on that shitty feeling, or and rising above it, redeeming yourself after it, and
shit it's all like about
that. That's
creative.
Powerful to me. That's like, oh hell yeah, that's something to fight for right there.
Just do your own thing. Be creative. Keep an open mind, of course. Mm-hmm. Till next time, everyone. We are two dudes
from Maine.
From Maine. And we'll keep doing this because we fucking love it. Two dudes from Maine. Two dudes from Maine. We have opinions. We always keep it open.